Hello viewer, welcome back to Artistry. Now we have our project at hand that we are making. We are making a stool, a standard stool. And a standard stool has a number of procedures. It's a simple item looking at it, but it has quite a number of steps towards making it. And as you can see on my bench, I have quite a number of tools that each and everyone is used at its own right time. So we came up to this far where we made the we explained the procedure of making the stands. Ama migu, tunazita migu za stool. Then we have the rail. Rail yet we go a bit wide. So we want to avoid putting another rail at the bottom because the stool has various designs. So you can opt either to have one rail or two rails. So for our project, I've decided let us put only one rail on top. So on top here, I have put a rail which is about 65 millimeters. We said we're going to be dealing with millimeters as we progress because our SI units are going to be in millimeters, in meters, or and so forth and so forth. For the stool, we have millimeters for our measurements. We have our stand, 35 by 35 millimeters. We have our rail, which is 65 by 20. 20 is the thickness here. And then the length, we determined it. So the length, as you can see from that end, you can see a little bit of the rail through this hole here. And also through this hole here. That means the rail has gone into the stand good enough so that we can have a firm stool at the end of the project. So from there, we have this one. We have this one. Now only two are remaining. We said we place them like this, and then we consider them to be exactly similar, so that we can have a stool that is stable. So we have the rest of the pieces here. I have cut them, and after cutting, I file it a bit. I file it using the wood file so that it will fit tightly. And then I label it also. So I'll fit F to F here. They should go in. And then I fit my other project. Let me see the labeling here. Oh, sorry. I have D to D. And then I have F to F. So I'll fit it that way. Then I'll fit them all together so that now my stool is taking shape. It is taking shape. So my stool has started now taking shape. It's time now to clamp them together. I have my F clamp. My F clamp will help me to press them together. As you can see, the part that I have clamped, it is now firm. I will use another clamp this side so that I can have the stool now well put together. So my stool now has taken shape. You can see the top of the stool. Now, the other process is now gluing process. But as I can see, the stool has taken shape. Now the next thing is to check on the diagonals. So the diagonals up here, 275, exactly. This is equal to that. I confirm again, 275, 275. So the diagonals are right. The markings are okay. So I confirm everything before the next step, because the next step will be gluing. And in gluing, we have different types of glues that we use. This is the ordinary PVA. We call it polyvinyl acetate, PVA glue. It's white in color, so I've put it in one of the waste bottles that we have around so that I can dispense it well, because it comes in a container 30 kilograms or 30 liters. So it's, you can't dispense it from the whole container. So I put it in one of the water bottles so that I can press a little bit of it and then I apply to the joints. Then we have this other type of glue that is common nowadays in our hardwares. It is known as the moisture glue. So the moisture glue will be able to be used to join parts even if the timber may not be very dry or cured. So that's why it's known as moisture curing or moisture glue. So you can use any one of those two types of glue among many others. We have many types of wood glue that we could use. So for me, for this project, I can choose to use one of these. So if I may decide to use the moisture glue, it's still okay for me. The PVA glue, or the just the ordinary glue that we have in our hardware and our stores, we have this glue. It's very common. This one is a bit expensive, but this one is moderately or relatively cheap. So you can use any one of them to apply now to the joints and just apply a little bit of it and then glue it. Give it, this one takes a shorter time to cure. It takes about 20 to 30 minutes, then it will be okay. This one will take longer. It may take about half a day with good climate, or you can clamp it overnight. Then the following day, they should be well. So this one takes longer than this. So this one is again more expensive. So now, after gluing our project, after applying glue and applying the clamps, then we are ready to fit the top. So the top will fit on top of the stool like that. And so the stool is still taking shape. But the top has quite some sharp corners, so they will be rounded or beveled. We can use the plane to bevel the top. Here we have the plane. This is a smoothing plane. It is used for finishing. It's a short plane, so we can clamp it, or rather we can hold it there and then just plane a little bit, turn it and plane a little bit, turn it and plane a little bit, and then turn it, plane a little bit on the fourth side. So the smoothing plane is very nice for finishing. So the top now has a very friendly top, upper side of the top. So I may as well do so to the lower part and then sand it with the sandpaper. So after sanding it, then my top will be very nicely fit there. So I'll just use some strips of wood to screw it from the bottom, and then you can see the end product that I'll have a very nice stool. So removing the clamps, now you see the final shape of my stool. So once I fit the the top nicely, then I'll be able to have my project, and you can bear me witness, it's a quality item. So one of the value addition for all furniture is the finishing. So the finishing needs to be very well done with the sandpaper, and then the polishing, the varnishing, and every other aspect around the stool, it should give it a very nice shape after the construction process is over. So for now, we'll take a break, and then we'll be back. Stay tuned.